Hello everyone, welcome to EC Learning YouTube channel. I am Rajesh Shelby. Today I am going to take you to the second part of history chapter 4, that is Age of Industrialization. It belongs to CBSE class 10. The most important questions and its answers are being dealt in a simple way in this video. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon. Kindly watch the video till the very end and leave your valuable comments in the comment box. So we can now move on to the first question of the second part of the CBSE Class 10 History Chapter 4, that is Age of Industrialization. What are the peculiarities of industrial growth? That is the first question. European managing agencies, which dominated industrial production in India, were interested in certain kinds of products. That is, as you all know, during the Industrial Revolution, India was under the rule of British Empire. They used all colonies, including India, for the welfare of their own country. So they were interested in only certain kinds of products. They established tea and coffee plantations, acquiring land at cheap rates from the colonial government. And they invested in mining, indigo and jute, which aimed for export purpose. By the second half of the 19th century, Indian businessmen began to establish their own factories but avoided competition with the English industries. By the turn of the 20th century, Indians began to boycott foreign goods as a result of the Swadeshi movement, as we have studied in previous chapters, and hence indigenous industries began to develop. But until the First World War, which started in 1914, as you all know, industrial growth was comparatively slow. The war created a dramatically new situation. That is, even though the Allied power under the Britain, under the leadership of Britain, took over Germany and other, it means Britain no longer continued to be the superpower in the world. Its repercussions could be found in the industrial sector also. The British factories were busy creating war-related products during the First World War. This boosted the chances for the development of Indian industries. The status of Britain as a world superpower diminished by the end of the First World War. Continuing with the peculiarities of industrial growth, the most important aspect of industrial growth was that small-scale industries began to be predominated. While factory industries grew steadily after the First World War, large industries formed only a small segment of the economy. That is, most of the economy, about 67% in 1911, were located in Bengal and Mumbai, or at the time it was Bombay. Over the rest of the country, small scale production continued to predominate. Actually, it was the growth in technology that led to the growth of industries. Weavers and other craftspeople who continued to expand production through the 20th century did not necessarily prosper. They lived hard lives and worked for long hours. The whole family worked harder. Their life and labor was integral to the process of industrialization. The British introduced their products in Indian markets and they persuaded Indians to purchase them. One way in which new consumers are created was through advertisements. As we all know, the role of advertisements in promoting products, it grew significantly during the early decades of the 20th century. At the very beginning of the industrial age, advertisements played a part in expanding the markets for products and in shaping a new consumer culture. The label was needed to make the place of manufacturer and the name of the company familiar to the buyer. But labels did not carry words and text at the time. They carried images and were often used beautifully illustrated. In the early part of the 20th century, images of Indian gods and goddesses regularly appeared on these labels. It was as if the association with gods gave divine approval to the goods being sold. The imprinted image of Krishna or Saraswati was also intended to make the manufacturer from a foreign land appear somewhat familiar to the Indian people. That means the images of gods began to be used in large scale for products, even those which were imported from Britain. By the late 19th century, manufacturers were printing calendars to popularize their products. Unlike newspapers and magazines, calendars were used even by people who could not read. They hung in small shops and outhouses, rich and poor, around the country. And those who hung the calendars had to see the advertisements day after day through the year. In these calendars, once again, we can see the figures of gods, and they were really used with a business perspective, that is to sell the products divinely. Like the images of gods, figures of important personages, emperors, nawabs, etc., adorned advertisement and calendars. The message was very clear that the quality of the products will be assured if the images of gods and goddesses were imprinted through calendars. When Indian manufacturers advertised the nationalist message, it was very clear and loud. Thus, advertisements became a vehicle of the nationalist message of Swadeshi movement. Thus, we have come to the end of this chapter and this video. Thank you all for watching the video.